From the studios of Farm Journal Broadcast, this is U.S. Farm Report.
Welcome to U.S. Farm Report this weekend. I'm Tyne Morgan, and here's what's in store over the next 60 minutes. Is the U.S. on the verge of another trade war with China? We have new developments. A tale of two wheat harvests this year.
It's turning into quite the slugfest to get things finished out.
From a rapid finish for farmers in Missouri to a sluggish start in Kansas, it's a battle with weather, turning a blank space into a work of art.
This time of the year, wheat is a phenomenal canvas for us to work in.
A big Midwestern welcome to Kansas City for Taylor Swift, and it's all powered by precision. And in John's world,
is China using slave labor to gain an economic advantage?
U.S. Farm Report, presented by Pioneer. What's next happens when blood, sweat, and tears meet rain, wind, and sun. Pioneer, what's next happens here.
Now for the news, it appears drought conditions have improved slightly across the country. Heavy rains fell this past week across parts of the Midwest, the Ohio River Valley, and the Northeast, and that led to improvements from southeast Nebraska to central Illinois, southern Indiana, and central and eastern Kentucky. But the latest drought monitor continues to show large areas of concern in the Corn Belt, including Nebraska, Kansas, and Missouri. And now 67% of the nation's corn crop is in drought. That's down 3 points from last week. And 60% of the soybeans are impacted by drought, also down 3 percentage points. Those rains also leading to some improvements in crop conditions in the latest report from USDA. USDA says 51% of the nation's corn crop is now rated good to excellent, a 1 percentage point increase over last week. But the soybean crop, there was a 1 point drop in the ratings from the previous week. Now 50% is rated good to excellent compared to last year's 51%. But crop conditions still dropped in several states last week, even with some rain. And that's the case in Nebraska. With little carryover effects of last year's drought, and central and eastern portions of the state have had very little precipitation this season, and it's resulted in declining crop conditions. USDA's latest crop progress report shows 49% of the corn crop was in good to excellent condition, down 8 points. Soybeans were rated only 43% good to excellent, a drop of 4 points. U.S. Treasury Secretary Janet Yellen traveling to Beijing this week. That's as concerns are now growing of a possible new trade war with China. The White House saying the trip was another step in the Biden administration taking to improve communications between the two superpowers, but no significant breakthroughs were anticipated. The meeting comes after Beijing this week announced export controls on two obscure minerals that are key to the production of semiconductors, electric vehicles, and aerospace manufacturing. And now the Biden administration is set to restrict Chinese companies' access to U.S. cloud computing services that use AI chips. Bart Ruth, the former American Soybean Association president, says relations between China and the U.S. haven't been this poor for 30 years.
The trade war in the last administration was a disaster. We didn't end up with anything better than we had, and damaged relations in the process. So, and that's my personal opinion, but didn't do us any good. So you kind of have to do a reset and move forward.
A Biden administration official told reporters the U.S. does not seek to decouple our economies from China, and adding that a full cessation of trade and investment would be destabilizing for both countries and the global economy. Well, one person died, two others were hospitalized after a grain elevator collapse in Texas. That's outside Corpus Christi, and it happened at R&R Commodities. The Bee County Sheriff's Office says they were called there on a report that two grain silos had ruptured and collapsed onto two 18-wheelers and another vehicle. People came from miles around, even volunteers with shovels, in an attempt to search for the missing employees. But investigators say one man was found dead under the debris. It's not known what caused the collapse. A new report shows last year a roughly 40% increase occurred in the number of reported cases and accidents involving ag confined spaces. The biggest increase, grain bin entrapments. A new study from Purdue University reported no fewer than 83 cases last year. 24 were fatal, and there were 59 non-fatal. That's compared to 59 total cases in 2021. Now, of the total number of confinement cases, 42 were grain-related entrapments. That's a more than 44% increase over the previous year and the highest number reported in over a decade. It appears farmers are feeling more optimistic these days with the new ag economy barometer rising again. The monthly survey from CME Group and Purdue University climbing 17 points to a reading of 121 in June. The index now sets 24 points higher than last year, but it's still down 16 points from 2 years ago. The increase was attributed to an improvement in future expectations, which was up 25 points compared to last month.
Producers in this month's Ag Economy Barometer survey became much more optimistic about farmland values. The short-term farmland value expectation index was up 16 points compared to last month, although that still left the index 10 points below where it was this time last year.
Surveyors say the rally in corn and soybean prices for harvest time delivery that got underway in late May and extended into June was likely a contributing factor to the increases. That's it for the news. Well, rain did fall across more of the country this past week, but it barely put a dent in the drought. We'll get an updated look at your forecast next.